George Sand was often accused of being an androgynous figure, of being sort of part man, part woman. And that was quite a common phenomenon in the 19th century. Any woman who had a bit of get up and go, and who lived their lives according to their own ideas of how life could be lived as a woman, were often accused of being unfeminine and androgynous. I mean, maybe that's still the case today to some extent, that it's you know, no doubt a way of controlling women's lives. But George Sand wrote in a huge number of different genres. She wrote short stories, she wrote some plays, she wrote journalistic pieces, she wrote novels. And she wrote very much for her own generation. So whereas her great friend Gustave Flaubert had a very strong sense that he was trying to write the perfect novel, Sand was writing to make a difference to her own generation, to her own society. So she worked in all these very different genres. And I think to answer the question, one has to sort of decide, well, what part of her oeuvre are we dealing with? So in the case of some of her novels, I think if you didn't know it was written by a woman, you probably wouldn't guess. On the other hand, there's a huge novel that she wrote called Lilia, which was published in 1833, which was a very bold exploration of female sexuality, female eroticism. And I think it's inconceivable that that could have been written by a man. So I think questions of gender in the novel are fascinating, not least because, after all, the novel really takes off when women are able to participate in writing. And so I think there's a really interesting question about the relationship between the novel and women and women's psychology. And, you know, so many of the famous 19th century English authors were indeed women. Now, I mean, there are different explanations for that. Obviously, all you needed was a pen and a book, and you could do it in secret. Whereas to be a great oil painter, you need different equipment, and it's more difficult to do secretly. But I think it's an interesting question, the degree to which women maybe do write differently or seek to write differently. I mean, I suppose the author I would say is the most quintessentially female would be Virginia Woolf, that there's something about the way Virginia Woolf perceived the world and expresses the world that I think couldn't be anything other than a woman's sensibility.